Duct tape.
So our friend Brian Perkins
had just taken a job at an ad agency.
And their client was Chevy.
And he wrote me an email saying, hey, my agency is doing a bunch of stunts with cars and they're trying to think of good ideas. Do you have anything you want to pitch them?
We sort of have a list of very abstract ideas that we might want to do for a video, and having a big field of instruments that were played was on the list.
I think at one point Damien's like, hey, maybe the handle on the car door will make a sound.
Or maybe we could figure out a way to make the car actually be the instrument.
But eventually the idea was to attach arms to a car and then drive it through an obstacle course of instruments and have those instruments play the song Meeting Getting.
It was a very broad art idea and a very specific set of technical problems.
Because the car is going to be moving, really the only thing you can do is strike something. I remember Brian and Damien got like every piece of material you can imagine to see what kind of sound those materials would make.
We thought about what things we already knew made sounds. Glasses make sounds. That's a pretty decent sound, right? So we looked for bottle suppliers and glass suppliers.
Pots and pans and tubular strips and all these things that we would just bang a rod against, see if it was a sound that we could tune.
So it was a lot of trial and error, and it was very exciting to hit something and be like, whoa, it's a note.
Damien called all of us down to this warehouse where they had collected all these pianos.
The crew in the video went and actually gathered every single upright piano in every thrift store in basically all of Southern California.
The job was to sort of figure out how to tune the pianos.
And the reason we did that is because when we drive past all the pianos, there's like a club that just hits this piano. And so we wanted to make sure that whatever note it was hitting, all the notes on the piano were that one note so that it couldn't miss.
D, D, D. Okay, yeah, this is good. I've been waiting for
months, waiting for you. I just kind of remember thinking like, this is kind of crazy, and Damien had to take stunt car driving lessons.
The guy who is the stunt driver in movies and trains other stunt drivers for movies was going to be employed to come teach me how to drift a car around in the desert.
There was a moment when we're going down the track and we're passing by hundreds of guitars tuned to one note. And right past the fence where those guitars were hanging, there was a cliff.
If Damien were to make a mistake, it could be really bad. I don't know. If he had lost control, I just wouldn't be here to talk about it.
Why didn't we have stunt doubles?
I remember the course seeming kind of complicated, actually. It was very long. Almost figure eight shaped. The pianos went out, and then the chorus was in the middle. Then we went out for the basses, and then back through the middle again. And then the guitar sort of went out on the side, and the last verse came back through the middle.
Even before arms were on the car yet, we hadn't figured out all the instruments. I did a bunch of training, and I started running what the course would be. This gave us a sense of how regular I had to be in driving. I started to get a feel for it and realized that the easiest way for me to judge my speed was not looking at the speedometer in the car, but actually looking outside the car to some other reference. So if you look in the video, there's actually red flags all along the driver's side of the track. There was a specific spot on the window frame I had marked in my mind that when the red flag crosses there, we're at the beat. Instead of an audio metronome, it was sort of a visual metronome. I would see it go tick, tick, flag, 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 flag. Once we had the red flags laid out that sort of marked my tempo of driving through the whole thing, we marked each beat. Those beats generally have an instrument at them. From within the car, you don't hear the music very well. You don't hear like da-da-da-da-da. You just hear boom, 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 boom. But they're in time or they're not in time.
It was incredibly surreal to see all these homemade instruments just strewn about miles worth of desert.
We didn't always know whether it was working or not because we were in this car driving really fast.
I mean, when we saw the final video, it was amazing. And you still have this thought that's like, are people gonna see the amount of effort in here? Get us another.
I love when our art projects keep leading us into places where we don't really know what we're doing and we're excited by the learning.
It's important, I think, to realize that the chair you're sitting on, the spoon you eat your cereal with every day, those things can make art. You just kind of have to think about them in a slightly different way.